Hello, everybody. Welcome to Housing Bubble 2.0 Deals of the Week. Yes, we're going to try something a little different today, so hope you enjoy it. And the reason being because I think things are picking up. We have access to a lot of stuff that's happening in the area. And quite frankly, I just can't keep calling people or emailing people and not knowing what they want to do. So I figure, you know, I'm just going to blast it out there on YouTube. People who want to get a hold of me know how to get a hold of me. If you don't, I'll tell you how to do it in a little bit. But either way, these are deals that you can grab right now. These deals are going to range from small to large, from, you know, a couple hundred grand, hundred grand to millions of dollars, multi-millions of dollars, depending on what we have that's flowing through the area right now. So this is the opportunity, everybody. So please enjoy it. Randy Patrick here, putting the realism back in real estate, putting the real estate back in realism. I don't know. Either way you want to call it, I'll do it. Okay. So again, these are off-market real estate deals of the week. So off-market means they shouldn't be in the MLS as of this point. If you look at this video 2 weeks from now, some of these properties may not be available, could be under contract, or could be on the MLS, depending how things go. So really, the opportunity is to jump on them now and inquire now, and we can facilitate whatever you need to happen here. And first of all, this video is brought to you by my partnership with foreclosure.com. So go to gethousingdata.com, that's gethousingdata.com, to check out distressed property listings in your area. Foreclosure.com is the number one location to find distressed property listings. You can get pre-foreclosures, auctions, probates, you know, all sorts of stuff going on in any location. So just check them out, gethousingdata.com. This will be very important for you to find out what's happening as the market changes in your location. So first of all, I want to start off with a property that we are direct on. And what I mean by that is we control the deal, we control the seller, etc. This is a cash flow rental or fix and flip deal in St. Petersburg, Florida. It has two structures on it, which is kind of cool. A main house, which is a two bedroom, one bathroom, 741 square feet. A back unit, which is 536 square feet. The cool thing about it is both these units or structures have separate electric and separate water meters. Looks like I spelt meter wrong there, so we'll just have to let that one go. I'm surprised that spell check didn't pick it up. But anyway, separate electric, which typically you find, but you don't always find separate water meters. So that's the cool thing. So if you were to be the landlord here, you'd have, you know, normally you'd have one water meter and have to build that into the cost of the rent. Well, now there's two separate water meters, so your individual clients or renters can actually, tenants can do that themselves. So the main house, which is the unit on the left picture there, just got a new roof and a new AC unit. And the back, so it does need some rehab, pretty much an interior rehab for the main house. And the back unit needs maybe, you know, it's not a huge rehab whatsoever. So it's a great opportunity for someone who either wants to do a cash flow rental or would like to convert this into possibly a fix and flip deal. Depends on what you want to do. The ARV, based on sales and potential like and actives and the comps that are going on here and the per square foot price, I'm looking at ARV of around 340 to 350K, so it's a strong number. Things are going for about 250 a square foot and more in the area. And the potential rent, so the rent potential rent is about 1,200 to 1,400 for the main house and about 800 to 1,000 for the back unit. So that's kind of cool. With the purchase price of being under 200K here, I'm not going to give you the exact price because obviously if you want that, you got to call me or connect with me, but it's a sub 200K purchase price. The rehab costs will depend on your exit strategy. So if you're going to keep them as cash flow rentals, you're not going to, you know, deck it all out, you know, with quartz and all the cool things in the kitchen and all these new, you know, unique things to make it pop because you don't need to for a rental unit. If you do want to fix and flip, then of course, you know, you'll do stuff like that and your rehab will be a little more expensive. But either way, so the rehab cost depends on the exit strategy. And I've looked at this a couple times here, and I believe the numbers actually work very well. I really do. Why? Because there's low inventory in this area. There's low inventory in the entire Tampa Bay metro area, including St. Pete's. St. Petersburg rental rates have increased quite a bit over the past little while. And I can tell you that every other day I'm getting a text or a phone call, or if I'm out of the property, and an inquiry as to, you know, can it be rented? Is it ready for rent yet? So people are looking for places to live. People want to live, you know, people need to rent. So there's no lack of, you know, put this way, you're not going to have a difficult time finding tenants for this place, all right? And as I said, the numbers work either way. So whether it's a fix and flip or a cash flow rent, the numbers do work, which is kind of nice in this instance. And I have intimate knowledge of this property and been in it many times, done work on it for one of my clients. And, you know, I can tell you all about it if you just want to reach out to me. So that's that one, and that's available right now. Okay. Next, what we have is something which is kind of unique. You're going to see this happening from time to time as people change and maybe they age out of the river. So we have a 15 single family residential package based in Tallahassee, Florida. Price point's about $2.6 million. This is, you know, what's in Tallahassee? Well, it's the capital of Florida. It's also where FSU, Florida State University, is. So all these homes, all these 15, are within the Florida State University area. Now, they're basically well-maintained properties, great occupancy, strong leases, and good tenants, which is kind of nice. And if you look at this, as I said, 100% occupancy. Many have recent roofs, new windows, new HVAC, like air conditioning units, flooring, recent appliances. So this is a great opportunity for someone who wants to jump in and actually have rental property in that area. When you do the numbers, just, you know, basically 15, you know, units into you know, 2.6 million, it's actually not a bad, cost per unit number is not too bad at all. So just keep that in mind. And that's, and the opportunity is obviously there that once you acquire them, then, you know, you can raise rent and things like that. So there's always, you know, a value add you can do, but this is available right now if you want to reach out to me. All right. Next, we have a multifamily opportunity. We get these from time to time. This is 98 units in Pompano Beach, Florida. So 98 units. It's a $12 million acquisition fee. So it's actually not a bad per unit cost there. Currently 98% occupancy rate. It's in an opportunity zone. So if any of you guys know what opportunity zones are, definite tax break advantages on your fifth, your seventh, and your 10th year, which is perfect. Each unit does have separate electric, which is cool. So they take care of electric themselves. And you, excuse me, you can see a little picture right there. Why do I like this? Because it's unique. I mean, there's X number of units per building. There's a few buildings on the grounds. I think it's a value add opportunity. And I did a little too quick here. So just keep that in mind that, this is what's going on here. So more people are moving down to Florida. So really, when they say value add, it's kind of like, well, if you can do some improvements to the property, then you're able to increase the rent rolls, etc. So it really boils down to, you know, getting a good acquisition cost per unit, looking at your CapEx expense, and seeing what the value add is. There's laundry facilities on here, stuff like that. So, you know, a lot of these units can be improved, etc. So just keep that in mind. This is available in Pompano Beach, which is the east coast of Florida, just north of the Lauderdale area. All right, so that's it for the three properties. Just so you know what I see. So there's other opportunities. So every day, you know, I get sent to me deals, and they could be stuff like this. They could be single family homes primarily in the area. So every day I see deals, so I do get access to them that, you know, through my contacts and friends and other real estate agents, etc. So I do get stuff, and again, the majority of them are off market, you know, ready to jump on. So that's an opportunity for everybody who wants to come down here and get involved with real estate. Personally, there's teardowns for development, so if you're looking to do some development, I think that's a great opportunity right now, especially in this area. There's land out there for development. Next video, I might show some land opportunities. I believe that a great opportunity is the build to rent or build, you know, just build to sell to flip it. Depending, again, it depends on what you put it, you know, what the cost profiles are and what you want to put in it, you know, based on your exit strategy, right? The build to rent, I think, is actually kind of interesting because if you do it the appropriate way, you can deck the place out in a way where you're not having to do, you know, refreshing and everything every time a tenant comes in another property. So we're also looking at container home opportunities as well too. Do have a lot of contacts who are doing container home builds right now in this area. So I think that's a great opportunity is to, especially now with, you know, a lot of material prices that are high, looking at some of these alternative strategies are really good. Multifamily, the smaller to the large, we get some pretty large ones that they're in our sort of our scope. Hotels, we do have some hotels across the country, some in Florida. And we'll get various office, you know, retails, you know, developments here and there, etc. So, and we will, as I said, the land for developments and the teardowns, like there might be an old structure. If you do some investigation, look at some zoning, maybe you can tear down an old strip mall and rezone it for multifamily, etc. So we'll see a lot of stuff like that. So that does happen in this area. So that's why you need to inquire. Now, we are direct, or we work with the direct. So when I say we're direct means that we have I don't use the word from an egotistical position, but we have control of the seller. So we have a relationship with the seller. It's our deal. And, you know, so there's no problems with engaging the opportunity in that perspective. Or we work with the direct buyer seller. What I mean by that is some of the stuff that we'll show you is that we have a relationship, done previous business with the person. who is the con who has it under control with the other seller. You know what I'm saying? So it's a legit deal. Simple as that. Now, to obtain more information, so if you say, Randy, I want more information on that 98 unit deal in Pompano Beach, well, here's what we have to do. First of all, anybody who's going to place offers need to see proof of funds. Simple as that. We don't send out information across the internet without seeing a proof of funds that, you know, you are a legitimate buyer or can afford this. Secondly, we do what's called an NCND. And what that is a non-circumvent, non-disclosure agreement. So if we're going to share with you information that we have obtained, and typically we've already signed NCNDs with our client, with the other agent, or them as well too. So if we obtain the information, you know, we're legitimately allowed to to utilize it under certain, you know, under the criteria of the NCND. So if we're going to provide it to you, then you need to sign NCND with us as well too. There will be a buyer's fee. So please understand that obviously, you know, we're in this to earn a living and earn income. So if we're moving a property and you're the buyer, certainly there's going to be a fee. The fee's negotiable. So, but just realize that, you know, there will be a buyer fee. We're just not going to hand you the information and not expect that we're going to be compensated, you know, for doing this. People have asked and people have tried. So just please be aware that's not how this actually works. You cannot daisy chain. What I mean by that is if I'm giving you a deal, and you know, you're not going to put it under contract and tie it up for 30 days and then email it to your list to see what you get. It doesn't work here. Typically, this stuff moves within, you know, 10 days, 14 days, it's closed. So, you know, you don't get to tie up things. We're not distressed, you know, homeowners here. We're real estate investors, real estate agents, developers, whatever. So that doesn't fly. So please be aware of that. But I have to say this because some people think they can do it. You might work with, again, unsophisticated homeowners or sellers, but not in our sort of scope of what we do here. If you are an agent and you have a buyer, then clearly we'll be happy to work with you. We'll need you to see your buyer's proof of funds and work out fee structure because we're typically getting paid on the buy end as well too. So we'll have to share you know, the wealth essentially. And there's no guarantee anything is still available. What I mean by that is if I'm showing you something today, it could go under contract tonight, tomorrow morning, the next day. And that's just the nature of these deals that, you know, stuff does move fast. If it's a good deal, it doesn't last very long. And that's what happens in this marketplace. So the faster you can react and make a decision, the faster you're going to go under contract and get a great deal. So that's how this stuff works. But I want to make sure that everyone understands that because it is important in this day and age. And people, you know, here's the deal. A lot of these, you know, certainly on there's some due diligence periods allowed in the larger, you know, multi-million dollar purchases. But on the smaller stuff, it really is, you know, you can't put under contract closing 30 days and have kick-out clauses for inspection stuff. It's kind of like, you know, do your walkthrough or have somebody walk through for you or explain to you the photos and videos, and you have to make a call on that, you see? So you can't tie up things for no reason, and that's just, you know, kind of how it works in this marketplace. So there you go. All right. So that's kind of the plan or how it sort of works, and it's straightforward. This is going to happen very shortly here, so I want everybody to know that you should be preparing for this. I obviously have programs, training, coaching, mentoring, whatever for this. And it's something I think everyone should be involved with because of the opportunity that's going to hit us in the next little while. Why do I think this is very important? Well, I'll give you an example here. And this is why I've spent a lot of effort in this. And I've started remarketing and got a lot of stuff on the go to bring in deals because this is the most recent information I can obtain for the Tampa Bay, St. Petersburg, Clearwater, MSA, Metropolitan Service Area. And it shows that, you know, in March, this is the most recent data for what I'm trying to show you here, that the median sales price for a single family home was about $300K. Well, if you look at the median sales price for a short sale, it's about $190K. So we got a pretty big discount there and a pretty big equity cushion. And this isn't even for trying very hard. So we know we can always do better out there. So my point is that with 5,000 homes sold in the area and only literally a handful of short sales, that means people aren't doing the business, and all these opportunities are out there. That's why you got to connect with me and engage me in what I'm talking about here. I can show you how to do it. I have all the data. I have access to all the people who are facing foreclosure in various stages, etc. So this is where I'm focused on the last housing crisis. I'm going to focus on right now. So that's the opportunity here. So this is, you know, people who are lamenting you can't find a cheaper home. There's ways you can do it if you want to take one or two extra steps and engage, and maybe, you know, save yourself, you know, 50, 100 grand in your pocket better than somebody else's pocket. Don't you agree? All right, that's the scoop on that. So how do you connect with me? email me, say you want to talk or about a property or an opportunity. Give me your phone number and your email, and we'll make sure we set a call. Typically, that's what I email you back, and we set a call. There are a lot of people email me the past couple of days. I'm going to be going back to them right now and go through that process and, okay, thank you. Let's set a call. Let's engage for the next couple of days. So that's the scoop on this, guys. So, again, something new I just thought I would try. We'll see how it flies here, but it's just easier than me e-blasting, calling people directly, et cetera. It's like, you know, I'm just going to put it out there because the medium exists. We can go from there. Eventually, I'll build everybody into a buyer's list, the ones that are serious, that want to do this on a bigger scale. Okay, guys. So, hey, thanks very much. Please like the video. Please share the video with your family and friends. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. And we look forward to working through the rest of our series on the top 10 reasons why we're going to have a housing crash and crisis over the next couple days. All right, guys. Take care.